Welcome to RP Hub. In this video, we'll discuss about how to convert Excel file into CSV file using Microsoft Power Automate. So in the complete playlist of Power Automate, you'll be able to understand how we can perform any automation flow without writing a single line of code. So let me show you the result of this flow, then we will create it from scratch. So if you can see here, I've created one employee name column which is in Excel file. All the data are stored into this file, and here this is a CSV file which I've converted through my code. So let me delete it, and once I will execute the code, same file will be generated again. So now let's execute the process and then we'll create it from scratch. Now we can see the progress is updated accordingly. Here we have the progress bar updated whenever the executions will be successful, and post successful execution, we'll see this data.csv file is generated automatically. So employee state contains the data of all the employee, and here we have copied all the data available in terms of ID and their employee name. We'll create it from scratch. Now let me delete this flow. Here, whenever we are generating a flow, we have to create it through Microsoft Power Automate. That is, we can use it, the create flow with a manual trigger flow. Click on new steps. Here, first we will add table detail. So we will just write get tables. When we are inserting get tables, this will ask us to enter the locations. So as of now, we are using OneDrive for business. Next, in library options, we'll select OneDrive, and the file locations we have to define it. So my file name is employee.xls. Now get table data is filled successfully, and we can see this manual trigger flow is already showing, but we don't want to use it. Next is, we want to call the list row present in a table. Again, locations will specify the same, OneDrive for business. Next item will show here, OneDrive. Again, file. So we'll select employee.xsls, and table name, we can see it here. So if you can see, the complete process does not require any single line of code to be written. Here, we are generating the complete flow very smoothly without writing a single line of code. Next item, we want to create a CSV file. So simply we'll write here, create CSV. Table. Now here we will specify the value from get tables. So we'll select your value, and we'll add some advanced options. Columns here I'm selecting automatic, but if you need, we can select the custom as well if you want to add any custom data. Next activity, I want to use apply to each. Now this is the control statement which will use it here. So again, we will specify the name from get tables. So apply to each will add the value of all the get tables and the name. So here we are majorly looking into the names, and after that we'll add an action item like create file. So simply just write create file. in OneDrive, I want to store into the same folder. Here, folder path, I will specify the root where I want to store the data. File name, I can include with the name of the file or data of the file. Otherwise, I can add the column name. Even I can select any of the names which will generate automatically. So when I'm selecting the file name, this will generate the automatic name. We can also specify .csv. File content. In file content, we will add output of CSV table. That's it. We have to just save it, and post saving, we can execute the process. So this will create a CSV file which we are looking for to be created in our Microsoft Power Automate flow. Once the execution will start, we can see the complete executions with the progress updated. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.